Had quite the windy Sunday across much of central Mississippi with wind gusts as up as 30 miles per hour in some cases. Here's a look at the resi, though. You can see the waves crashing into the rocks here. Some white caps all the way through, too, and that breeze has got a chill to it and causing our temperatures to plummet all throughout today. Here's another view, though, from the spillway there. You've got the dam, and you've got those waves toppling over the dam. This is shot earlier today as that wind continued to push that that water. That's a northerly wind that's causing that those waves to go over that dam. So really was an active day in terms of the wind here, and we did have showers earlier this morning, but we've dried out today. Now we've got a few peaks of the sun moving through the clouds, and those winds still out there too. You see the sky cam here just shaking on through. The high today in the mid 70s, but that was set earlier this evening or morning, where we said 75 degrees, and we woke up again to that mild start, because now our temperatures are plummeting. We're in the 60s already, into those lower 60s here in Jackson. We got that northwesterly wind moving on through, and our friends that are still down here under that cloud coverage down in Brookhaven and Hazelhurst, they're in the 50s and the lower 60s for them too. Those temperatures are what continue to drop for tonight. We're going to get down to those 40s all throughout the central part of the state. Our friends up here for Kosciuszko, Carthage, into those mid-40s. Some of them lower 40s, too. Some low-lying areas could get down into those lower 40s. But tomorrow's all going to be a faint memory. It's going to be comfy out there. Temperatures in those 70s. So get ready for another nice Monday, because moisture levels are going to be fairly low, too. Here's that cold front that has pushed through, causing for some less moisture as we get into the beginning part of your week. However, we got another system we're having to watch that's going to come through, pulling in more moisture and more rain, and in some cases, a few rumbles of thunder too. So starting off the week dry, as we do see cooler temperatures for your Monday, but that races on off towards the northeast. We get more of that rain to be pulled into the area. As that next system pushes through, that cold front could have a few thunderstorms embedded with it. Not looking at anything severe right now, but still something to watch for. We're in spring. We still get those patterns when we do get a few storms moving through. However, we got behind that cold front, this next one's going to be even more chillier air into those mid-30s by Friday, on Good Friday night. So get ready for that. If you have any plants, be sure to watch out for those plants and have a way to cover them, because you never know how cold it can get as we do get into this Friday. So for tonight, we'll be in those mid-40s, clearing up for tonight and into tomorrow, the lower 70s. A nice day panning out for your Monday. Coming into tomorrow night, though, those clouds increase once again in the upper 40s, making way for some more rain to come in by Tuesday into Wednesday. Again, a few rumbles of thunder possible Wednesday evening, but that brings in a cold front. Look at our temperatures plummeting as we get into your Thursday and Friday. On Good Friday, looks like we'll be down into those mid-30s overnight. Some patchy frost will be possible, so be sure to watch out for those plants, but we stay in those 60s.